Hey guys, so it's been a little difficult finding you guys the good news because it's been a tough week and I personally have just been binging on Dhoni's videos. I want you to tell me in the comments on what your favorite moments of Dhoni were. Anywho, I managed to find quite a lot of good news for y'all other than all of this happening around. So here's your weekly dose of positive, wholesome, non-negative, not-for-profit, legitimate headlines. Well, you get the point. So the coronavirus pandemic has made us do things that we did not think were possible before. Like staying at home for so long, wearing masks, doing a good news home edition. Jokes aside, the Australians have figured out the best discovery yet. In Australia, the treatment plant is using expired beer and turning it into renewable energy. It has been recycling 150,000 litres of beer every week, which is enough to power like 1,200 houses. Using beer to convert it into electricity has seen a record energy generation at the plant. But yeah, it's official. Beer is the best drink out there. India took another big step last week when it comes to inclusivity in the transgender community. In Kolkata, a private bus operators association, which has a fleet of about 30,000 to 40,000 buses, have decided to reserve 2 seats for the transgender community in this affiliation of the buses. Not only this, but the transgender community in UP will be able to inherit agricultural land, which was not possible before. The UP cabinet cleared an amendment to the UP Revenue Code of 2006, which includes the transgenders in inheritance laws. So being a Mumbaikar, when somebody talks to me about rains, I'm hardly ever surprised because I think I've experienced all the rains to last me a lifetime. But I'll have to admit that the residents of Switzerland recently got a special rain, which actually got me pretty jealous. The Swiss town of Olten received a sweet surprise as it received chocolate rainfall. Yeah, you heard it right, chocolate rainfall. So actually, there was a defect in the Lindt factory cooling system which was located over there, which caused a cocoa snowfall. Now that's a rainfall I wouldn't mind having all day. Gamers are trolled for practically no fault of their own. They're stereotyped as people who just sit all day at home and play games and waste their time, and quite frankly, I do not agree with that. Do you know how much skill is required to play PUBG? Anyway, all that aside, the good news is that the world's biggest video game developers have come together to form an alliance to raise awareness about renewable energy and climate change through the UN's initiative called Playing for the Planet. The alliance consists of 11 companies and 25 design studios. They hosted their first ever Green Mobile Game Jam, which asked the best gaming minds to come forward with educational solutions to spread awareness about climate change. So this piece of good news comes with a little bit of a lesson. Keep trying no matter what, because you never know when you might strike gold. 2 years ago, the Global Wildlife Conservation promoted the 25 most wanted list of lost species. These species were not found for like 30, 50, 100 years, but after so long, the list of species has gone down to 20 after 5 species were rediscovered. So the 5 species that were rediscovered are, I can't say this, I'm going to read it. Jackson's climbing salamander, Wallace's giant bee, velvet pitcher plant, silver-backed chevrotin, and Somali sengi. Well, that's it for this week, folks. If you know of any other positive headlines that you think we've missed out on, please put them in the comment section below. Also, do share this with as many people as possible because everybody could do with a little positivity right now. Just because it is cold and locked does not mean that you have to necessarily step out, so try and stay in as much as possible and watch out for good news every Monday with Binge Daily. Asha out!